Hi, I'm Andrew from Ford and Doonan Air Conditioning. Today, we're going to talk about how to save money in running costs and how to get the best performance from your ducted air conditioning, be it summer or winter operation. Okay, let's first talk about the main system controller. In this case, we've got a Daikin controller shown here, but what I'm about to talk about, it applies to any brand of air conditioner, no matter which one it is. So the first question is, what temperature do I set it at? Everybody asks that, and it's a very, very good question. So the rule of thumb is that for every degree you drop it lower, it adds about 10% to the running cost of your air conditioner. So the goal is to set the room temperature as high as possible on cooling mode, whilst not sacrificing comfort. So at the end of the day, your comfort's most important. So if you're not cold enough, keep dropping the temperature down, but don't get it too low. So for example, if you set it to 16 degrees, the air conditioner is never going to get to 16 degrees and cut out or slow down. Therefore, you're calling the air conditioners to run flat out and consume the most amount of energy. Where if you set it at 24 degrees, the air conditioner has to do a lot less work to get to 24 degrees before it starts saving you energy. So the higher the setting on cooler mode, the better, and it's going to be around 23, 24 degrees, but every house is different and you may have to adjust yours outside those parameters. Next, we're going to talk about zones, and no matter what sort of zone controller you have in your ducted air conditioning system, again, the information is going to apply to it. So the rule of thumb is that the reason why you've got a zone system is because your air conditioning system isn't large enough to do the whole house at any one time. And that makes sense why you don't want to air condition the whole house simultaneously. So therefore, how is it best to use the zones? Well, in short, the less zones you have on, the better, because the less of the home the air conditioner has to cool or heat. So the less zones, the better. But of course, if you're in a room, you need it air conditioned, so you turn that on. So if we look at this little picture here, you see we've got this room off, this room on, off, and these other ones are different percentages. So if you've got a controller where you can set the volume of percentage open, that gives you another level of control to just an on-off zone controller. But regardless, the less zones you have on, the better. If you turn the whole house on, it won't do any harm to the air conditioner, but it certainly will make the air conditioner struggle to try to reach room temperature. Okay, the next question we get often asked is, what time of day should I start my air conditioner? So let's assume we know it's going to be a very hot day, 38 degrees, really anything above 36 degrees, it's going to be a hot day. So we want to be fair on the air conditioner. What isn't fair on the air conditioner is to come home from work at 5, 5:30, turn it on, and then expect the air conditioner to bring down into comfort conditions within half an hour. That just is not going to happen because obviously the house has got a lot of thermal mass of heat created in the brickwork, and this won't happen in very short, quick time. Okay, so what time do we start it? Generally speaking, the hotter the day, the earlier the time of day you need to start your air conditioner. So generally, definitely by lunchtime, on a day of 36 degrees and above, we'd recommend you start your air conditioner. Now, is that going to cost you more to run it? Probably a little bit, but probably not as well. If you want comfort conditions, which is what we all want air conditioning for, this is the most important thing. So let's just have a look at this here. So virtually all air conditioners these days are inverter driven. So what inverter means is that the compressor, the motor in the outdoor unit, speeds up and slows down in response to the room temperature. So in other words, it'll work a lot harder when you first turn it on. Like in this case here, you can see it come up. It runs at a high speed for a short time, and then once it gets near the room temperature setting, it'll then speed up, slow down, maintain that temperature. So this is how an inverter saves you money, where the old air conditioners, they used to just go like this up, and then just run, be off for a short time, then back to full power, run, back down like this. And this, of course, is consuming the most power, and this is when it was consuming no power. But the inverter has leveled all that out. So don't be unfair in your air conditioner. Don't wait till 5 or 6 o'clock. Make sure you start it earlier in the day, hotter the day, earlier in the time you turn it on. And let's not forget, most air conditioners now have remote control via their app, so you can even turn it on from your office if you did forget before you left work. Next, let's talk about some more performance tips and more how to save those dreaded running costs of the air conditioner. So the first thing is, and one would think it's pretty obvious, is make sure you close the doors, windows, and the curtains. Direct sunlight is the enemy of air conditioning, and it'll just make your air conditioner run too hard, too long, and your power bills will go out of control. So first thing is, especially direct sun, so west and east facing glass, should always have the windows closed, obviously, and the curtains as well to stop the ingress of that heat. So by minimising every opportunity where heat's getting in is the first step. The next step is, if you've got a zoned air conditioning system, is to remember to turn off the zones that you're not operating. In this case, in this example here, we've got a bedroom that's turned off and a theatre that's turned off. So we're doing less and less of the house, but it's also important to make sure we shut the door leading to those zones that we've turned off. That way, the return air grill, which is sucking back all the air from the remaining outlets, is not sucking air in from this spaces here or here. So we're effectively sealing off the rooms that are not being used completely by the air conditioning and with the door closed. That'll make a big difference as well.